parents and family. What we're going to do is we're going to do a quick thing for the game, and then afterwards we're going to stick around some gifts for the girls and all that, so we'll say that after the game. First thing I'd like to do is I'd like to bring up the one senior from Windham High School, number 21, Nikki Lemay. Okay, apart from the two active players, we also have a senior who is our team manager. She has been here since the start of the school year. She finishes this whole year. I think personally she's very brave, being 17, coming over to the United States on her own, not knowing anybody who could do a strange state, loving the snow and the cold weather. Right. One thing I would say about Tanya is, and I think all the girls will agree, Tanya always has a smile on her face. All right. She has been an awesome person to have with us on the team. She travels with us to every game as well. She's been really a special person to have with us for the season. And I really want to thank you, Tanya, for being so nice. Don't cry. Right. So what I'd like to do now is bring out her host mom, Shauna Kirkpatrick, to come up. If anybody would like to take some pictures. She has not complained or whined or been upset with anything to do with this season. She's accepted her role. She's been a wonderful teammate. She is the master of air braiding. And she has just been a very supportive teammate and has been a pleasure to have on the team. And right now what I'd like to do is welcome her family down. So our parents, Kathy and Greg Flagel, along with our sisters, Stephanie and Holly Flagel.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Goffstown High School basketball. Tonight the girls take on the Windham Jaguars, and my sidekick again tonight on senior night is Scott Gross.
It's senior as in like high school seniors, not senior,
well, yeah, senior
citizen.
Senior citizen, that's what I am.
Okay. So it should be a pretty evenly matched game, Al. Both teams are, Goffstown's 8-8. The Jaguars from Windham are 9-7. They look to be evenly paired.
Yeah, I think it should be interesting. I noticed that Windham's got a little more height, but Goffstown starts out in a 2-1-2-3 zone, and ball knocked out of bounds by Walsh.
So tonight's senior night, and we've got a couple of seniors that are on the court right now. Number 12, Abby Flagel.
Shot taken on the outside by Windham. Rebound taken
that hit
underneath.
The strap. Yeah, so Abby Flagel and Casey Britton Doucette were honored before the game. This is their last game at home as a senior.
I think it's Casey's had a pretty good season playing for Goffstown. Now we're going to have a hold on, looks like it's going to be on Windham. It's going to be on number 10, Scheibel. That'll be her first, team's first.
Yeah, it was a tough one to see if they were going to do that, or it was almost a moving screen.
It was close.
Yeah.
So Brennan with the ball on the point. She gets it over to Walsh. She's looking to drive, drives the lane, puts the shot up, no good, fights for a rebound.
It's going to be Goffstown's ball. They've got the possession arrow. Good job following her own shot.
Brennan goes to inbound and gets it outside. Brennan takes it, drives to the hoop, takes a shot, up, no good. Rebound fought for underneath and taken by Windham.
Yeah, that's one thing that
they push it up quickly.
Olivia Brennan has been able
nice steal that time by Edmonds.
Brennan's been able to do a nice job.
Breakaway to the basket, goes up, no good. Rebound, fought for, taken. Here we have another jump ball. Good hustle by Flagel.
So Brennan does a good job, you know, driving the lane. It's just that finish. And I think as a freshman, that's going to come. And when that does come, Goffstown's going to be a deadly team. Nice pass.
Great pass inside that time.
Scheibel with the two-point bucket.
Walsh with it on the side. Gets it into the post. Nice give and go that time. Just a hair late. Shot taken outside. That time by Britton Doucette. Goffstown's pressing. They're doing a zone press. Gets it up.
No problem breaking that one.
Three-point shot taken from the outside by number 12, Borsciani. And it puts Windham up 5-2. Brennan for Goffstown bringing it up.
Nice crossover dribble.
Crossover dribble. Three-point shot taken by Goffstown. Nope. Rebound taken that time by Brennan.
Nice move.
Nice up fake that time by Edmonds.
But no finish by Edmonds. Great up fake and move on that one.
Cross court pass.
Another shot.
Another three-point shot taken. Rebound taken.
Long rebound.
Good job defensively that time by
That was
Edmonds.
A great job by Edmonds.
Good box out. Good rebound. Brennan gets it inside to Doucette. To Edmonds. Over to Walsh. Back in the corner. Brennan looking to drive, takes it back out. Windham playing man and man. Ball knocked out of bounds by Windham. By Schleibel. Olivia Brennan will inbound the ball. She gets it over to Walsh. Britton Doucette into Flagel.
Nice
she drives
move.
To the hoop. Takes the left-handed
nice
layup.
Nice job by Abby Flagel.
Good layup. Nice drive.
Really nice up fake there. That was a walk.
Nice block that time by Edmonds. By Britton Doucette.
They're going to call Flagel, I think, on a foul. But I thought she had all ball.
Yeah, fouls on Flagel. That'll be her first, team first. And going to the line is going to be Adamson for Windham. Shooting two.
They call that on Edmonds.
Oh, they did?
Yeah.
Still the first for the team. Missed the first shot. Second shot, no good. Rebound
taken. Good box
taken.
Out.
Good job by Walsh boxing out the shooter. Brennan takes it up. Goffstown looking to try to get the lead. Britton Doucette over to Walsh. She drives the lane all the way up. Left-handed layup. It's good. Goffstown takes a 6-5 lead. No press. They back up.
She does a great job on those drives. She uses her body to create.
She goes left-handed on the left side, which is fantastic.
Yeah.
Forced pass inside, picked up that time by Walsh for Goffstown, and she pushes up, gets it on the side of Flagel, kicks it back out. Brennan with it on the point. Goes down to the post. Britton Doucette.
She got fouled, though.
Gets hit by from behind. That's going to be on LeMay. They'll be here first.
And that's the team's.
Coming in is number 24 in. Didn't catch the other one. Brennan fakes, drives to the hoop. Good
and
shot.
She got
it.
Yep.
Gets the basket.
See, that's the thing.
Very aggressive.
Yeah, she's got the moves. She's just got to finish the shots. And when she does, this team's going to be really strong. Is if you can get Walsh and Brennan to drive.
That time, good job by Goffstown.
That was a foul, not a jump ball. She had her on the arm, but it's going to be Goffstown's ball anyway.
I like to bring that ball down to the to the waist. Walsh back over to Brennan to break the press. Windham doing man-to-man. Now Brennan's being covered by Adamson, which is a taller player.
Yeah.
32. Edmonds gives it over to Brennan. She drives to the hoop.
There you
go. Makes the basket.
Nice job by Olivia Brennan. Also going to the left.
Yep. Windham tries to go into the paint.
Nice job by Edmonds.
We're going to have a job by Edmonds. They tie her up.
It'll stay Windham's ball. Good hustle by Edmonds.
Good position that time.
Yeah, that's something that you can't really, you got to really be cognizant of. You don't want to give that type of position up.
Britton Doucette with it, gets it in.
Got to be careful
Flagle
on that.
She lost control.
Yep.
Good defense that time, I thought, by Walsh, but
she got her on
she
the
reached in
at the end.
So that'll be her first, and the team second, and going to the line will be Scheibel. First one's good. And coming in for Goffstown is going to be Cammie Durham.
Nice job by Abby Flagle.
Wonderful job. Now there's a team player for you. Shots up, it's good.
That cuts the lead to one.
Britton Doucette on the outside.
That's a forced pass. You don't want to do that.
Windham trying to come up quickly.
That's a travel.
Oh, we'll have a jump.
That's a travel, not a jump ball. I mean, I can't believe he called that a jump ball.
Goffstown's going to call a timeout, 30-second timeout here. I want to mention about Flagle. You know, being a senior and playing basketball like this, and she hasn't seen a lot of action all season long, but she's been to practice. She's worked hard. She came out here tonight. She got a starting role. She got herself a basket. I think it says a lot for her attitude and the way that she's treated the team as a team and not worrying about individual play. And
yeah,
I think
you don't always see that a lot, Al, especially in high school sports.
No, you usually see a lot of it's me. And so congratulations to Abby.
You know, what people forget is that when you're playing, it doesn't really matter what sport, you're scrimmaging against your own team.
That's right.
So you need people to practice against to get better.
And you got to make the kids work. Walsh outside, looking, trying to get it into the post. They do. But
oh,
then
another
Cammie
giveaway.
Durham.
Woo! Nice move.
That was a good move that time. That was by Davis.
Too many turnovers. That's going to be Windham ball.
No, nope, he's calling it for Goffstown.
Okay. I thought it went off a Goffstown player.
It did. I thought so.
He got overruled.
Nope. Yep. So Windham has a one-point lead right now.
So what's happened over the last three offensive possessions? It's been turnover, turnover, turnover.
Forcing the ball into the middle. Nice steal by Walsh.
She read that lane.
Back to the point. Good move. Nice layup. Boy, hard to believe she's a freshman. Windham with the ball. About a minute left.
Great pass inside.
Missed. The rebound taken by Windham.
Who scored that one?
That was 33. That was
Adamson.
Walsh with it. On the point. Looking for some help.
She got two screens.
Drives in, takes the layup, and it's good.
Kelly Walsh with 6 points, leading the score for Goffstown. Gustin's got to get some defense here. Again, you cannot, you're getting too many rebounds by Windham. So Britton, Doucette, or Edmonds, they got to put a body.
LeMay comes back in.
On Adamson. Yeah, because Adamson was getting some good boards. Again, protect that inside.
Ooh, look at that.
And they did, they didn't do it again.
Good stop behind by Edmonds.
And that's a Cammy Durham's responsibility.
Yep.
She's guarding the inbounds pass.
Three-point shot taken outside, no good. Rebound fought for, taken by Edmonds. Brennan drives inside, and wow, she did not get fouled?
I thought they grabbed her arm.
That's what it looked like from here. So she'll inbound the ball with 22 seconds. Edmonds, nice job getting inside the
beautiful
paint.
Job by Jess Edmonds. That's her first bucket of the game. So again, Goffstown needs to be protecting the paint.
Now,
and so far,
man to man.
Okay.
Yep.
Good defense by Goffstown. Nice rebound by Doucette, Britton Doucette.
Three-point shot from half court.
Oh, misses it.
And just missed.
But Goffstown leads, 16-13, and they've played real well in that first quarter.
They had that one spurt. When Flagel went out, they moved Cammy Durham in, and they tried to get the ball into the post to her. I think part of it was the defense for Windham didn't think that Flagel would be in a post position.
Yeah.
So she was a little more open, whereas with Cammy being a little bit taller, they're more aware. They went after her, and they forced the ball in, and they couldn't
get turnovers. Oddly enough, too, is when they're trying to get the ball into the post position, the post player is too far out, so they're really only passing it into maybe like 3 or 4 feet of space.
Yep.
Much, much more difficult because the defender can kind of lay off the passer.
And the thing is that they've got to get the ball to them when they're coming
cutting,
up,
yeah.
Not when they get there. Once they're there, defense is back in position. But that's fine. I mean, they'll get through that.
Like I was saying before, Al, I think, you know, I think Olivia Brennan can be a difference maker in the sense that once if she's able to dribble penetrate and actually make her shots, this team is going to be really unstoppable. But you can't just, you know, double up and defend Walsh all the time. You got to right. have another weapon.
Well, the nice part is they're not taking outside shots to be in the game. They're driving to the hoop, which is great. Now there, that's exactly what they yep. need to do. Nice job by Edmonds.
Edmonds got to give it up now.
She gives it over to Cammy Durham. Behind the back dribble. Kicks it back out. Walsh will take it. Behind the back, drives to the basket.
That was a good no.
That was a good block.
That's a good no call, and Durham lays the hammer. on 32, Steph Davis. So that'll be Durham's first.
The team's third.
Not that many fouls called. The refs are letting them play.
Definitely.
Haven't seen Sophia Perez in the game yet.
Good job by Cammy Durham.
Great
nice
defense. Move. Oh, my goodness gracious. A travel is good. Okay. I was going to say, if they call a foul on that one.
So a travel on Windham that time. I thought that was a nice block by Edmonds. Brennan with the ball. She gets it in the corner to Walsh.
Brennan has a really good crossover. That is a hold on 32, probably. Let's see who it's on. 3-2, yep. That's Steph Davis. That's her first and the team's third, I think.
Brennan will inbound the ball. Gets it inside Edmonds. Gives it back to Brennan.
Gets it back inside to Edmonds. There you go.
She was doubled up.
Yep.
She should have kicked it back out, but.
That's a
nice attempt at giving the ball, but boy, I'll tell you, Edmonds got away with that one.
Yeah, Edmonds got away with a foul on that one.
Speaking of Perez, she comes in the game to replace Durham.
Much more animated Goffstown coach tonight. He's been standing up the whole game.
Well, this is important for them because they can get two more wins as a possibility of them hosting a game.
Oh, a block by 32. That's why it's good to put a taller player.
Good hustle by Perez that time for Goffstown. Almost got the ball back.
You know, I know Kelly Walsh. I coached her when she was younger in softball. She's really a competitor. I'm curious to see. Nice pass.
Great breakdown that time by
Goffstown. To number 24, Nina Burney.
In the corner, Perez takes the drive, kicks it over to Edmonds. Back out to the point to Britton Doucette. Over to Brennan. Takes a three-point shot.
That was
wild. No good. Nice rebound that time by Walsh. Took a shot. No good. Rebound fought for in the knee, taken by Windham. And then as they tried to pass it out, they get knocked out of bounds. So Goffstown maintains possession with a one-point lead here. Perez on the point. Takes a drive, kicks it outside to Brennan. Three-point shot up.
Oh!
Wow, gets the Goffstown bounce. Three-point shot was good.
And she's quickly back on defense, which is good.
Nice hands by Walsh. Ball goes.
That was a travel.
That was a walk.
That was a travel. They missed it.
Yeah.
Even Coach Horseman was like, what's the deal with that one?
Good defense that time by Edmonds.
And Perez who has done a really good job on the boards all season.
Walsh, three-point
nope,
shot.
Nope, not even close.
No good. Rebound. They're going to have a jump ball, and the ball is going to go to Windham. And La Rochelle checks in for Edmonds.
Like that substitution. I like bringing La Rochelle in here. She's a pretty tough, gritty player. She brings her and Gifford bring a sense of intensity to the team.
They bring that. They're not afraid to drive.
Yep. They're not afraid to drive, and they're not afraid to hack if they need to.
Yeah. Oh.
That was another.
Hello, stepper.
Yeah.
Shot outside by number 12, Perez, with the rebound underneath for Goffstown. And they move it up quickly. Walsh with it. Brennan drives right to the
and
hoop.
She
and
gets
now
fouled.
She gets fouled.
This is a little bit of a difference that we're seeing in Brennan than we did a lot of these previous games. Brennan has now taken it to the hole.
Yes. That foul was on Walsh for
the other Walsh, Kaylee yeah. Walsh.
So Brennan will go to the line and shoot two. First one's good. Gives Goffstown's largest lead of the night. 20-15. She'll get a second. That one's off the back of the rim. Rebound fought for
See,
by
See, that's
La
what I like about La Rochelle. She's always yeah. in the mix.
Scheibel drives for Windham, gets it in
One,
the middle.
One, two, three.
She got into the land of.
They're not really calling any 3 seconds, and Windham's got to be
nice
careful
look.
About that.
Nice look.
Nice job by. Nice great pass to yep. La Rochelle, who puts 2 points in on that lay-in.
Nice look that time. Good block by Walsh. Drive to the hoop for Windham.
Excellent
and
job
good.
By number. That was 13, right?
Yep.
Really nice drive.
Perez brings it back up quickly. Looking inside for La Rochelle.
La Rochelle was open there for a second.
Britton
Again, she's open. She's cutting across the paint, Al, and she's getting open.
Yep. Good drive to the hoop that time. By
oh,
Brennan.
In and out.
La Rochelle with the rebound goes back up. Wall was blocked. Good job, though. Windham loses control.
Jump ball.
And we're going to have a jump.
Goffstown.
Good substitute coming in. Davis will replace Orsiani.
Yeah, Windham substituting quite a bit.
Perez got it. Looks like a man-to-man press. She brings it up. Good pick. She drives right to the hoop. All the way, coast to coast. Yeah. Nice job. 7-point lead for Goffstown now. Windham looking. Gets it into their post person. Doubled. Gets it back outside. Takes a shot. No good. We're going to have a rebound.
Is that a foul? Three. number 22, La Rochelle, with the foul. That's going to be a three.
No, it was after the shot. Oh. After the shot. So coming into game is going to be LeMay. She replaces Adamson.
Goffstein has a luxury here. They've got three players who can really dribble. And you've got Perez, Walsh, and Brennan who can all break a press and bring the ball up.
Yeah.
Has Britton Doucette gotten any break yet?
No, she's been in the whole game.
All right.
Drive to the middle that time by Scheibel. Basket's good. Looks like they put the tallest player on Brennan. Davis covering her. Good pick that time by
That's a good play, and she got a block.
Yep. Whoa.
She walked again.
Three-point shot that time.
Nice
by
shot.
Number 13, Walsh.
She stroked that one. And that now it's a two-point game.
La Rochelle drives, kicks it back out to Brennan. She goes into the paint, Ooh. Kicks it back out, resets the offense. Perez with it. Britton Doucette with a three-point shot.
Nice job.
Good.
She's played really well today.
27-22.
Nice Windham. Up fake.
Shot, no good. Rebound fought for in the knee. La Rochelle goes to the floor, kicks it over to Brennan. She drives up quickly, continues to the hoop.
Oh, my God. How do you not call a foul there?
Look at the hustle on La Rochelle picking up that loose ball. Britton Doucette with the ball outside. Kicks it into La Rochelle. La Rochelle goes
and
up.
And she gets fouled by number 15.
That was a great hustle play by La Rochelle when Brennan drove to that hoop. The ball was up in the air, and La Rochelle just came out of nowhere and picked it up. So she'll go to the line. La Rochelle will go to the line to shoot two. The foul's on Walsh. That's her second. Is she the leading scorer on Windham?
Who?
Walsh.
She's got five. Nope. Scheibel has six.
Yeah. La Rochelle's first shot is off the back of the rim.
La Rochelle struggled a little bit at the line this season. Something that she might want to work on, you know, in the off season.
So she'll get a second.
But she, like I said, she brings so much intensity to the boards.
Great. That one's good.
She makes that second one. Like I said, she brings, I think, a defensive spark.
Good hustle that time by Walsh, almost stealing now for Goffstown. Ball kicked into the middle.
There's a three. They're not calling 3 seconds.
No.
And
rebound
they're just camping out underneath there.
Again, Windham with another offensive rebound.
Yeah, but Al, I got to be candid here. You can't just stay in the paint for 5 and 10 seconds at a time.
Goffstown trying to go too fast. Brennan throws the ball out of bounds. It'll be Windham ball.
Yeah, if you watch the pay now, you'll see that it's not even 3 seconds. It's more like 5 and 6 seconds on some of these. Because you got to clear both your feet out of the paint.
Looking to drive. Takes baseline. Nice baseline drive that time by Windham, by Davis.
La Rochelle. She's not the guard.
She takes it up. Ooh, she got.
See, that's a sloppy play. Again, La Rochelle has good skills. She just got to, be a little bit heady on these situations. She is not the guard, so there's no need to really bring the ball up. You get the rebound. You wait for your guard play.
Well, bad pass into the middle, picked up by La Rochelle. Perez takes it, kicks it out the wall. She drives into the middle, goes up. Right-handed layup this time, and good.
That's her 8th point of the game.
3-point shot by Windham.
Woo! Is that 13?
That was number 13, yeah. Walsh.
That's
30-27.
That's her 8th point, all leads. In this quarter.
Brennan drives right to the hoop. She's blocked out of bounds.
I like that, though. You know
right
what?
Davis.
In for Windham, number 12, Emily Orciani.
Checks
and he's playing. In. He's playing almost his whole bench.
Ball goes in to La Rochelle, kicked back outside. Perez takes a 3-point shot. No good. Rebound taken by Lara Schell.
There she is again.
Puts a shot, but it's a foul on number 21, LeMay.
There she is again. She has a nose for the ball.
Yes.
I mean, she just does.
She's not afraid. She's very aggressive. She's not afraid to go after it. First shot's away.
That looks
good.
That was a beautiful free throw.
Great arc. She'll get a second. That one's off the back of the rim. And it's taken by Windham underneath. Under 20 seconds
again,
to go.
Britton Doucette's been in the entire quarter.
Half.
First half, yeah. Again, keep 33 out of the paint. One,
good defense.
Two.
Oh.
Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. You can give that foul. That's a good foul, actually.
Foul's on Walsh.
Yeah, that's okay.
That'll be here second.
You don't want to.
It was an incidental.
Yeah,
foul,
you don't want to cheat me here, but.
Good
great defense by
Perez.
To end the first half. What
wow.
A great defensive play by Perez.
Nice job.
So Goffstown leads at the half, 31-27. And a really, you know what, this is a great game by both teams.
Has been. It's almost been just as Goffstown starting to take the lead.
Very pleasurable to watch.
Windham comes right back, and the referees are letting him play quite a bit.
That's right. We're going to take a break here for halftime. We'll be back in 10 minutes.
And welcome back here to the second half. Goffstown girls basketball. They lead at halftime, 31-27. Windham will take the ball in first. Goffstown, man-to-man pressing.
Now, that was a really good first half of ball on both teams.
We got a kick that time
it's
by
only,
Goffstown.
It's usually a kick ball when you intentionally try to stick your leg out, not when someone throws it off of her leg.
Yeah, but it's below the knee.
Yeah.
It'll count. He's going to take it out underneath the basket.
How come?
Because it was inside the three-point area.
Again, so. Goffstown has to be careful. They weren't defending the paint area on inbounds passes. Now they are.
Doing a great job. Nice job by Perez that time. If you watch, Lara Schell had a good boxing out of the player that time.
Number 33, right, Adamson?
Yeah. And you're watching them. That's what they're looking for, is to try to get into their post. Shot up, no good. Rebound taken by Wendell.
Hey. Sorry for my
taken
exasperation
LeMay.
There.
Windham full court pressing. Brennan with the ball. Gets it inside to Doucette. Lara Schell drives the hoop. Goes up.
Nice
basket
job.
Good.
By Allie Lara Schell.
Oh, what a great job that time by Perez as a Windham player. Walsh was turned around and she handed the ball to her, but
she's right
she
there.
Traveled.
Yeah.
Great defense. Great job by Goffstown that time.
Perez plays really good defense, and she gets a ton of rebounds.
That was a good heads-up play. Ball goes inside to Lara Schell. Ball knocked out of bounds by Goffstown by Britton Doucette.
And she has not had a break. She is Britton Doucette has played this entire game.
Windham.
Nice move.
Goes to the hoop. Good steal that time by Walsh. She brings it up. She's going to go right to the hoop.
She got
basket.
Fouled.
No good, but she is fouled. That'll be on LeMay, number 21.
That's her second. And that's
Walsh will go to the line for
the
two.
First team. Kelly has 8 points in the game so far in the first half. And she makes that
first one.
She's had good success in the free throw line throughout the year.
Bernie comes in for LeMay, for Windham. And Walsh will get her second shot.
And like I said earlier in that first half,
that
she makes
good.
The second one. Windham is substituting at every opportunity. They're bringing in fresh players. So that could mean something in the fourth
Ball goes into the low post. Double team that time. Good job by Britton Doucette coming Warren. Over and help. But she didn't get any help that time. Rebound fought for underneath.
And there's Perez.
She kicks it up quickly. Kicks it out to Walsh. Walsh takes the three.
Nope.
No good. Rebound fought for. And there is LaRochelle again.
Doucette had an opportunity to get that ball. She didn't go for it.
Perez goes to the floor. Ooh, looks like steps there, but rebound taken by Walsh.
That's a foul.
Brennan. Kicked out quickly to Walsh. Walsh goes right to the hoop. And we're going to have an offensive foul.
I don't know about that, Al. I don't know. Maybe she lowered her shoulder, but it didn't look like the defensive player had any position whatsoever.
Well,
and
that's
her
out
third.
For the first time, and
that's Kelly Walsh's third.
Cammy Durham comes in. And now Gagnon is going to report in for Walsh. So some offense is out of the game for Godstown. So if they, let's see what they, how they set things
well,
up.
Well, now you're going to have to see some offensive production from Brennan
Perez.
And Perez.
Well, and Durham has been.
Yeah, Durham's done fine. And same with LaRochelle. I mean, she's been able to score. One.
That'll be a backcourt violation. Good defense that time by Glasstown, forcing the pass out.
Coach Horseman's talking to Kaylee Gagnon.
Perez kicks it out tied to Gagnon. Loses control, gets it over to Brennan.
Kaylee Gagnon's got to be smart with the ball.
Yeah.
You're in there as a substitute. You don't want to turn the ball over.
Cammy Duren goes to the paint. Gets it taken away, but then it's fought for.
That's going to be a jump ball.
Yep.
Goffstown's ball.
Goffstown ball.
Again, I know Coach Horseman's looking to buy some minutes here to keep Walsh off the court. She's going to pick up a fourth foul. But, again, you're losing some your offensive production here.
LaRochelle with it.
Pass it out.
Back inside the Durham. Nice job by her. Takes a shot, no good.
And that could have been a foul on 22.
I think it's going to
and
be.
And it is. Yep. Again, that's what I'm saying before about just really good intensity, but you got to temper that and know what the situation is. No need for a foul there.
It was almost like she lost her balance and just kept going that time.
So Goffstown has a six-point lead. They got to be really careful here. Again, your main threat, Kelly Walsh, is on the bench with three fouls. Great
good
defense.
Good job that time. Unlucky for Windham, but good for Goffstown. Brennan brings it up quickly. Kicks it back outside.
And she got lucky. See, that's another freshman mistake, I think. She dribbled into the corner, Al, and then she got, pretty much nowhere to go.
When she had her open, she didn't pass it. She waited until it was too late. Perez with it.
High screen by LaRochelle. She doesn't take it.
Kick back out to Brennan.
Again, here's just a good example. Just kill some clock.
Perez up fake, takes it inside, shot, no good, rebound fought for and taken by Windham.
See, Perez has got to get back there. Trouble here for Goffstown.
Ooh.
That's a charge.
Yes.
Thank you. Good job by Olivia Brennan.
She just stepped right in.
She stood in there and drew the charge. Her dad was pretty happy with that one. Scott Brennan sitting in the front row. Very proud of his daughter on that one. Number 13, Kaylee Walsh. That's her second. And
Edmonds.
She's going
to give LaRochelle a break.
LaRochelle. And I think good move there. Edmonds had a solid first half.
That's going to give him a little more offensive power,
I think. Yeah, 4.5 minutes in the third.
Perez looking to drive. She takes it down. Kicks it back out. Gagnon takes a three. No good. Rebound.
She gets her own rebound, though.
Long rebound. Nice job by Cammy Durham that time.
Couldn't finish. Luck. She gets her own rebound.
Good hustle.
They're going to reset the clock here. Reset it.
Whoa.
It's going to be off. It's going to be Goffstown's.
Yeah. I think after she got hit in the face.
Yeah. It's amazing when you get hit in the face and there's no foul called. But.
Yeah. Okay, Perez on the front court with it. She's starting to drive, kicks it outside to Brennan.
And that's going
to
be a hold.
That's going to be on number 10 on Scheibel.
And that is her second. Team's third.
And Brennan's going to take it out underneath the basket.
Man, they have got, Perez open all the time there.
Nice job there. Perez gets her own rebound, puts it up and in. Drives the baseline, get her own rebound, and then gets her second shot.
Okay, just got to play some stout defense here.
Ooh, that was a walk.
That was a travel.
Good job, that.
See, I hate that. When you get a good rebound, and then someone puts their hand in there, because they bring the ball so low, it's just a matter of grabbing it.
Yeah, we're going to have a foul on Perez.
Yep.
But she got kind of sandwiched in there.
Did she throw the ball up? She did. Okay. Yeah.
So Scheibel will go to the line and shoot two.
And then she misses the first one.
She'll get a second. It's a good opportunity for Goffstown right now to be a little patient. Go
right.
back to
that's,
driving. Go
that's
back
what I'm
to
saying.
Driving to the hoop.
Right. I mean, you know, there's no problem. You don't have to, you know, 20 seconds put a ball up here.
Oh, and Ellen didn't touch anything. So it should go out on the side, not underneath the basket. So Brennan will take it out. Full court pressure applied by Windham.
See, that's the beauty of having a Perez, you know, who can bring the ball up.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. That was a stiff. That was a
wow.
Did you see the screen that was set by number 10?
By
Jess Edmonds?
Jess Edmonds? Yeah.
Oh, my goodness.
It's like running into a stone wall.
Wow.
So that foul was on 32 on Davis. And Perez will go to the line and shoot two. First one's good. Foul line could be Goffstown's friend tonight.
Seems like the officials are calling a little.
Only missed one or two.
They're calling a little bit more the second half. That's going to be a miss. Oh, she makes it.
Second one's good.
They're calling a little bit more. So now it's a 10-point lead for Goffstown with Kelly Walsh, who's been sitting on the bench for the last 4 minutes. When
she'll
she picked up her.
Sit out the whole third
well,
quarter,
it
which
depends.
Would be good.
Ooh,
nice
that was touched by Windham.
By,
so yep. That'll be Goffstown's
Gagnon
ball.
Gagnon got her hand in there, and it deflected, and then the Windham player touched it, went out of bounds. And Perez gets it back to Brennan. Again, they're doing full court pressure. Not a lot of pressure, but Brennan kicks it outside to Gagnon. She got lazy on that one. Good drive that time, and we're going to
charge
an offensive.
Wow! You know what? I know we're homies, but that did not seem to be a charge to me.
Nope.
On Steph Davis, so that'll be Goffstown's ball. They caught a break on that one. Maybe that's a makeup for. Got to get some help here.
Hey, Perez with it gets it back to Brennan. Again, a soft.
It's a soft full court press, but it's. Nothing there.
Brennan kicks it over to Gagnon.
See, Gagnon's got to be careful with the ball. See,
there he is. Same
again,
play.
See, I take her out of the game for that. That's two in a row. And unfortunately, you can't do that. And that should have been
that
a foul.
To a basket that time by Bernie. For Windham, Brennan brings it up. And we're going to have a technical foul.
On who?
On the coach. Now she's got to sit the bench. Or no, it's a warning.
A warning. So now Gifford comes in, and I think that's a good move. Kaylee Gagnon, just in that in her sets there, just two easy giveaways. Ooh, got to be careful. Backcourt violation.
Yep.
Another rookie mistake. So between Gagnon and Gifford, that's when you have your inexperience on the court. You got to play heady ball. But again, these are also good learning opportunities for these players who are all young.
True. So Windham's got the ball. They lead. They trail by eight.
Nice
Give
pass.
Give and go inside. She took that dribble, hurt her. Kick back outside.
That's a foul.
Travel.
That was a travel.
And now we're going to have a foul on
Perez? No.
Nope. It's going to be on Durham. Or no, on 14, which is
Gifford.
And Brennan takes a break.
Yeah, okay, you got to bring Walsh back in the game here.
That was a nice job by. Gifford did a good job that time.
You don't want to. It's an 8-point lead here with 2 minutes left. You got to be. Now it's two. That's five team fouls now. Gifford comes in 1 minute. She's picked up two fouls.
Ball sent jump in the middle. Ball. We're going to have a jump that
That'll
time.
That'll be Goffstown. I mean, I know you want to rest your players, but guess what? These kids can play all the time. They don't need a break.
Okay, Durham has it. She takes it up court. Brings it all the way up. Gets underneath the basket. Kicks it over to Gifford, who's blocked. Rebound taken by Gifford.
That was a good drive.
Yep.
Oh. Oh. Well. 12's going to shoot a three.
No good. Rebound taken by Edmonds. She gives it over to Perez.
Again, there's no rush here for Goffstown.
Right. Perez double teamed. Ball taken by Windham on a steal. And then Cammie Durham comes from behind and fouls number 10, Scheibel.
So this is the problem for Goffstown, is that they have picked up four fouls in less than 2 minutes. So Durham picks up her second, and they're one away from putting Windham in the bonus. And now you're going to see Monique Saroy check in.
No, Minnick.
Is it Minnick? I'm sorry, Minnick.
Rebound fought for underneath and knocked out of bounds by Gifford.
And she's going to come in for Gifford.
Yep. Well, and now they're adding more height.
Well, you lose a little bit of intensity with Gifford out, but I think you get a little bit more ball handling with Minnick.
Good job. Oh,
don't call. Don't. Are you kidding me? That's an awful call by the referee there. Sorry, I try to be positive on these things, but that was a really bad call.
Fouled by Edmonds. That'll put them in line to put 1-1.
That was a really tough call. I think even the folks on the sideline down there, the fans, were very surprised about that one. So that'll put Windham.
That's Bernie at the line for 1-1.
Right. So this is what I was saying. Goffstown picked up five fouls in about two and a half minutes.
First shot is good.
And if there's one way that a team can come back in it, it's on the free throw line. Because well, these cheapy fouls stop the clock.
Chances are they could end up in a situation where foul line ends up by being Windham's friend. Rebound.
That's an over the back.
Durham gets it over to Edmonds and then back to Perez, who brings it up. Again, don't have to rush this.
Again, I don't understand this at all, guys. I don't. See, you can see Coach Horseman is kind of – I know what he's trying to do. He's trying to get to the fourth quarter. But in the meantime, your 10-point lead is now at 7.
1 minute to go, under a minute to go here.
And there's really no rush for what Perez did there. I mean, just bring the ball up and get into your offensive set.
Right.
Kill clock.
Goffstown into a 2-3 zone. Ball taken underneath.
That's a foul.
Yep. We got away with that
one. Who got that point?
Basket. That 33. Was 33, Adamson. Minnick brings it up. She's got it outside. Gets it into Edmonds.
That's a tough.
Yeah, now we're going to have another. Oh, we're going to have a jump or we're going to have a hold. We're going to have a foul on. That's going to be on Davis, I believe.
And that'll be their 16th foul. So number 33.
No, that was on Adamson.
I'm sorry, it's Sam Adamson. I apologize. Yeah, it's her second.
Perez takes the baseline jumper. No good. Rebound fought for underneath. Taken by Durham. Good offensive board.
Again, you got 17 seconds. Use them. That's who Minnick. I'd want the ball with Perez.
Kicks it back out to Minnick.
Minnick's got to shoot that one. She's got to shoot it.
She does. Takes a three.
Oh,
off the front
almost.
Of the rim. No good.
All right. So Goffstown leads 39-34 going into the fourth. And really, that was a situation where Coach Horseman needed to give Kaylee Walsh and Olivia Brennan, his starters, some breathing room. And Britton Doucette also sat down. So I'm curious to see what happens here in terms of the fourth quarter, Al.
Yeah, and he also he had took Lara Sherrill out earlier. And so he has some rested players, starters to put back in that he can use. It'll be interesting to see how he's going to approach. And again, they're trying to push the ball up, and they really don't have to.
Yeah.
They can get into an offensive set. But, you know, you lose your – when you don't have – I mean, I know Perez does a good job ball handling, but Brennan seems to run that
point. Brennan is the point guard. So in that third quarter, it was 8 points for Goffstown, 7 points for Windham. So it's a very, very low-scoring third.
And Goffstown
more fouls, too.
Five,
if you notice, the game – it was very much flowing in the first half. Not that many – fouls were called. The third quarter, it was foul city.
Yeah, Goffstown ran, got a little bit out of control. So Walsh does check back in. Minnick stays in. So so Brennan will stay on the bench for now.
I wouldn't expect her to be out of the game all that long.
Well, Minnick will run the point.
And now she's
going to have a travel.
See, this is the reason you want to give your younger players some playing time, but with only a 5-point lead, this is an important game for Goffstown. You got to put in, you got to go do or die here with your best five.
Windham is looking for post playing. They get it into the middle, kick it back out, shot taken outside that by Walsh, number 13.
And Walsh is the shooter on this team. If there's anybody that you don't want to be shooting, it's her.
Edmonds kicks it outside, kicked out to Walsh, 3-point shot, no good. She gets her rebound.
She follows.
Drives up, no good. Fights for it, gets the ball back out. Good hustle by Walsh that time.
You're going to reset it.
Perez.
Good hustle by Doucette, Britton Doucette and Walsh. Keeping that ball alive.
Perez takes the sideline jumper. No good.
That
rebound
was not a good shot.
Taken by Windham. They push it up quickly. They're big people. Handle the ball pretty well.
They do. I think if you get a score here, if you're Goffstown, if you give up a score.
Oh, that was a step.
Oh.
That was a travel.
I call a timeout right here if I'm Horseman.
39-38.
She goes into.
Walsh goes in. Takes a shot. Up and good. Kelly Walsh puts him back on top. They had a 10-point lead. They're down to two or three. Good hustle by Walsh. She's going to steal it. She's going to go right to the hoop.
And she got fouled.
But she gets the basket.
That puts it a 5-point lead. Let's see if Brennan comes back in. And she is checking back in with about 6 minutes left in the game. Nice move
that
by
time,
number 33,
Adamson.
Sam Adamson.
Minnick with it. Looks, kicks it inside. Yeah. Perez takes the drive to the hoop, and
she
she's
gets fouled. So that'll be a shooting foul, but it also is the seventh team foul on Windham. So that'll put Goffstown into the bonus as well for any more fouls here. So Perez.
She'll shoot two.
We'll shoot two, and we're going to see Brennan come in.
And Laura Schell.
And
first one's up, no
good. It's a miss.
So Laura Schell comes in, replaces Edmonds, and Brennan replaces Minnick. Perez will get her second shot. This one's up, and no good. Off
Misses
the back
the
of the
second.
Rim.
Again, you don't need a cheap foul here,
right?
Because you'll put them on the line. So this is a 3-point lead for Goffstown. It's been a phenomenal game here, folks. Two pretty evenly matched teams.
They keep looking for low post play.
Yeah.
Again, good job going to the floor for Walsh.
And there's going to be a timeout called by Windham.
By Windham, a 30-second timeout.
Good job by the Windham coach. Because all these possessions matter at the end of the game, Al.
Yep. And that possession would have gone to Goffstown, I believe, right?
Yes. I tell you, you couldn't ask for a better game than for a senior night. This is great.
Yeah, I think Goffstown just got a little sloppy defensively here in the third quarter. And
this is a young team, undeniably a very, very young team. And when you look at the production that you're getting from these freshmen, and then on top of that, you know, you're looking for your bench to contribute, but your bench is a lot of them are freshmen.
This is an important game for Goffstown because this could put them in a tie with Windham. And by beating them, it puts them ahead.
Yeah.
And then all they got to do is beat Timberlane in the last game of the season.
Could be five seconds.
Wow.
That's over the back, too.
Finally.
And that will be sending Goffstown to the line.
That's on 32. That's on Davis.
And that'll put Goffstown in that's her fourth, if that is. If that's number 32, that's her fourth. I have it as her fourth foul.
Yeah, they got it as three.
Unless I gave somebody a wrong one.
Probably did.
All right.
But it happens.
I know. So Walsh,
you won't get docked. Walsh first shot, no good. And the ball picked up by Windham. They'll bring it up.
Again, 3-point lead with under 5.5 to play in the game.
And they're looking, all they're looking for right now is
it's low post play, yeah.
Yep.
And so far, Goffstown has
post.
They've done pretty well defending it. Good switch offs.
Yep.
Good job by La Rochelle coming over. That's
good
a travel. Really nice job, La Rochelle. She slid her feet over to defend the baseline.
So Brennan will bring it up. Getting the light pressure. Stay man to man. Brennan.
Tough pass. I don't like that pass at all.
Get three people in there defending.
Call a timeout. And that is a timeout by Coach Horseman. He saw his point guard got trapped in the corner. Guess I'm getting a little animated here, Al.
Yeah, they're going to do a 30-second timeout. You know, thing is that I don't understand why we're trying to go low post
against a
zone right now they're playing.
Yeah, you don't need to. As a matter of fact, if they're playing a zone, just keep passing the ball around. I mean,
you've got to make them come to you.
Yeah.
That's what you have to do against a zone because they got the lead.
And not to mention the fact that you've got Perez who can hit the three. You got Walsh who can hit the three. Britton Doucette can hit the three.
So it'll be interesting to see what they're going to adjust.
You know, Brennan only has an upside in terms of, like, right now as a freshman, she sometimes presses the issue a little bit too much. Got to get the ball in.
Yep, again, it's all one-on-one. There's no picks. They don't try to open each other up. They just try to get the ball to the first person that runs away.
Well, the other thing, too, is that do you want a 5-foot
nice block? That's a jump.
That's a jump ball.
It's a jump ball. Goes to
Goffstown. Great block. Do you want your 5'3" or 5'4" point guard bringing the ball in? That's another question you have to ask yourself. Sometimes you want a taller player.
Well, she has a good field of vision. She just doesn't have that height to – see, watch what we're doing here. Okay, Walsh will get it back in. Brennan brings it up quickly. She's looking for La Rochelle coming up.
See, that's
the
what
post.
They're doing now. They're putting a lot of height on the point guard.
Yep. Perez gets it over to Doucette. Back out to Walsh. Again, patience. This is what it's got to be, patience. Walsh fakes. Perez with the ball. Smart play. Gets it inside of La Rochelle. Up. No good. She fights for the rebound.
I like that play, though, on La Rochelle's part. Yeah. That was a good move. They're going to shoot that one. Nope. They're going to, again, there's been no scoring in the last 2 to 3 minutes. Both teams have put up goose eggs. And that ball's turned over by Windham.
Yeah, they attempted a give and go that time, and ball was passed too far ahead. Okay, Perez gets it back to Brennan. She brings it up. Kicks it over to Britton Doucette into the middle to Lara Schell. And fortunately for Goffstown, Walsh picks it up.
3.5 left in the game. Crossover dribble by Walsh.
Brennan drives. Shot up, no good. Rebound taken inside.
Nice job by Lara Schell picking up the rebound and putting it back in.
Yeah, Britton Doucette got the first rebound.
That's a 5-point lead for Goffstown. About 3 minutes to play in the game. Looks like Cammie Durham is going to check in.
Again, low post work.
Another block.
We're going to have a foul on Britton Doucette.
Oh, I thought she had all ball on that.
Yep.
Probably she thought she had all ball.
So she'll be shooting two underneath for Davis, for Windham.
So that's number 13. That would be Britton Doucette. I think it's her first foul of the game, and she's played so many minutes. That ball
off the back of the rim.
And looks like
Cammie Durham checks in for Doucette. Nice
Doucette
job by her.
Doucette has played an awesome game. Got to get the rebound here. Box out if you're Goffstown.
Second shot off the back. Rebound by Lara Schell. Kicks it over to Brennan.
Good rebound by Lara Schell.
Gets it over to Walsh.
Again, clock is your friend here.
They got three good ball handlers in there with Brennan, Perez, and Walsh.
High screens everywhere.
Good job. Good patience. Walsh looking. She tried to get in.
She forced that one.
Lara Schell up. No good. Rebound fought for.
That's
going to
be Windham ball.
Whoa.
It's Windham ball. That should be Windham's ball. They're going to talk, but.
Nope. He didn't get overruled, so.
Yeah. Good job by the officiating, though. I mean, you know, you should talk through these. And there was one play before earlier where the one official overruled the other. That's good when they do that. They talk. High screens everywhere for Windham. Again, they're looking to get the ball in down low.
Shot outside. No good. Rebound fought for underneath.
Awesome box out by Lara Schell.
Kicks it right over to Perez. Again, patience here.
Ooh, watch out
Durham
for that.
Takes an outside shot. Good. Rebound fought for underneath.
There's no need for Cammie Durham to take that shot in that situation. Right. It wasn't a clean jump shot.
Looks like we've got Edmonds is checking back in. Not sure who she's going. She's going in for Lara Schell.
Who called the timeout? Is it us?
Goffstown.
Okay.
So we got a 45-40 lead for Goffstown. Again, right now they need to be just patient.
Yeah, I agree.
They have the lead. They need to be patient. I mean, don't give up the easy shot, but, I mean, continue looking for that layup if they have it.
The other thing, too, is Windham is really pressing the issue in terms of guarding Kelly Walsh. They're putting much taller defenders, and the Windham players, not only are they pretty tall, but they're pretty quick. And so it's a good matchup for Windham defensively because Walsh is going to beat him off the dribble, but then can she get the ball over their hands?
Right. And once she beats her person going to the basket, person from the weak side has got to move toward the basket, so she's got someone to pass
dish off to. Yeah.
And that's we're not seeing that happen either.
I'm not sure if it doesn't look like Lara Schell is going to be coming back in for the final 2 minutes and 11 seconds, but let's give Allie Lara Schell a big hand round of applause.
Oh, she did
played
a great job.
Awesome.
Yep, wonderful job. So Edmonds gets it over to Perez. Back in the corner to Walsh. Whoa. She takes the drive to the hoop. And again, this goes back looking on the other side.
Yeah, so she's gonna go to the line.
Shoot 1-1.
1-1. So the next foul, which is important for Goffstown because with a 5-point lead, they're gonna have to foul at some point, so they'll be in the double bonus. So Kelly Walsh will shoot the 1-1. And she missed her first attempt at a one-on-one earlier.
She doesn't miss many. In and out. Good rebound by Edmonds. Got good position that time. Look at this, double the
double
team.
Yeah, because it's the height. Yep. You know, the height can do that. Now 33 is looking for position.
Inside. Ball thrown out of bounds. It's going to go to Gostan. So you can see what they want to do. Now Gostan has to adjust that.
Got a helper.
Oh, we're going to have a foul
on number 10.
Windham, number 10.
Number 10 on the hold.
On Walsh, that's send her to the line. Now that's going to give her two shots.
Tough break. Allie Scheibel, if I'm sorry if I pronounced your name wrong. I'm not sure that was a foul.
I think she grabbed her arm.
She did?
Yeah, that's what it looked like from here, but, you know.
I didn't see the Windham coach wasn't arguing too much, so. So Walsh will now shoot two. They're in the double bonus with 1 minute, 41 seconds left.
First one's no good. She'll get a second.
So Kelly, who ordinarily shoots really well free throws, she's missed her last three. She's 2 for 5 tonight. And she misses that. Oh, she gets that one.
In.
All right.
So a six-point lead for Goffstown.
Two-possession game for Goffstown.
Again, they're all looking low post.
Yeah, but here's a situation where just don't do any cheapy fouls.
Rebound taken underneath, and we're going to have a travel. Two Goffstown players on the ball. Minute 25.
Again, defend the paint.
Kicked outside, Windham with it. Great job by Edmonds stealing the ball. Brennan bringing it up. And she'll get fouled. Good job.
That's a great move there. Nice sportsmanship by Windham. She puts the brakes on, and the Windham player couldn't control her body, and you get a cheap foul there, and that'll put Brennan on the line shooting too.
Yep. Good court vision.
That's heads up
ball.
Yep.
First shot's away, and that one's
good. That's
good. And she'll get her second.
And she misses that one. Again, Goffstown needs to be smart here. You don't want any cheap fouls. You got a 7-point lead. So it's three possessions.
That was a travel. Rebound taken by Walsh.
They're going to have to foul.
Gets it over to Brennan.
She's got to get out of trouble.
Yep.
There you go.
Pass
it out. You got to pass it out.
Oh, they're trying to foul her and they're not. Oh!
Oh, my goodness gracious.
She walked in front of her. She wasn't even set.
Yeah. That's her fourth foul. That's not a good call, but you know what? 47 seconds left in the game. They've got to put in two three-pointers here, so just guard the line here, folks. That's
good steal by Walsh.
Bring it up. You don't need the basket. You don't need the basket. Smart job by Kelly Walsh.
And we're going to have a foul.
On Scheibel.
Yep.
And that should do it.
That's a makeup call.
Yep. That'll put Walsh on the line again. Kelly Walsh
fouls.
Has
those five fouls on Scheibel.
Yeah. Kelly Walsh has 15 points, and she'll be shooting two. She's Goffstown's leading scorer.
First shot's up. That one's good. Puts Goffstown up by 8.
Overall, Ali, you got to be impressed with Goffstown's effort tonight. They played well as a team. Had some, you know, little lapses here and there.
Second shot, she gets her own rebound. And she's being fouled again. That time's going to be on 13 by Walsh. I think that's going to be it for her. That's
her fifth, yeah.
Yep. So it looks like Minnick's going to check in
for Brennan.
For Edmonds. And Bernie comes in.
Saroy comes in.
Oh, for Minnick.
Nope, Saroy's
Saroy?
In. Number two.
My bad. Monique Saroy goes in to replace Durham. Walsh's first shot is good. She'll get another chance. Second one is good. 10-point lead for Goffstown with 24 seconds.
And that should do it, Al. I mean, they might be able to put up a three here, but, again, you don't need to. Nice move.
Good
by
drive.
Number 32.
Yep. She went right to the basket.
Yep. Oh, I don't know why they're doing this.
They have a foul on number 12. Oh, it's on offense.
That's ridiculous. That's a joke.
That was a hook.
She fouls out. That's a joke. Kelly Walsh fouls out. That was she's got to just deal. And she doesn't want – don't show up the referees there. Just sit on the bench.
Tammy Flagel's going to come
in.
Abby Flagel.
Yep.
I'm sorry.
So 8.7 seconds left. Number 32, Steph Davis. She puts in her first one.
She'll get her second one as her bonus.
And she makes a beautiful, beautiful free throw.
Timeout, 30-second timeout called by Windham.
I mean, I've seen stranger things happen in basketball games, but they're down six.
Well, he gets six.
Was it like 8 seconds left?
They're probably going to end up by doing is trying to double up the ball and try to force a bad pass and then go right to the hoop. Because that's one of the things they've been doing tonight is they've been putting a taller player on the point guard. But the driving, one of the things that was very successful for Goffstown in the first quarter was the driving to the hoop. And they kind of got away from that.
So let's just assume with 8.7 seconds left that Goffstown is going to hold on to this one. Maybe to get the ball in.
Flagel gets it over to Brennan. She's fouled. Ooh. Yeah, we have an intentional foul.
Yeah.
On 32 on Davis.
So I think game changers. I think we had somebody take a little spill in the bleachers here. I think we're going to interview Britton Doucette, right, today. And let's put Allie LaRochelle, right?
Yeah. How about Abby?
And Abby. Yeah.
Why not?
Yeah.
First shot is no good by Brennan. She gets a second. And then Goffstown will get the ball.
I tell you right now, Goffstown struggled at the free throw line today, big time. And ordinarily, they're usually pretty good.
A big advantage for Goffstown going in to their next game is they need to continue driving to that hoop. So Brennan will inbound the ball in the backcourt. And Perez has it. And she's fouled, but they didn't call anything. They're letting it go.
I don't know why the coach had him do that. But anyway, great victory for the Goffstown Lady Grizzlies, 51-44. Kelly Walsh was the leading scorer for Goffstown. I'll tell you, I think... You know, as a form of a recap, I just think that they just played really well together.
Yeah, they had, even by having two seniors starting, they did well.
All right, I'm going to go get the players. Scott Gross, I'm here with Allie LaRochelle. Allie, you're a bench player. You come off the bench, but you bring a ton of intensity. What's your mindset when you come into a game, especially a close one like this one?
I think when I go into a game, I try to match the vibe that my other teammates are setting when they go in, and we have to keep that intensity up to keep a good rotation going and keep the flow of the game going.
You seem to always be around the ball. I mean, you're getting rebounds like crazy. I mean, what's your method? What's your approach?
I don't really look at anyone as taller than me. I try to get them all. I see no height difference when I go out there.
You know, one thing we noticed when Al and I are calling the games is that, you know, someone like you, you come in, you bring like a toughness to this team defensively. It kind of changes. I don't know if do you ever notice that yourself?
I kind of feel it sometimes. Yeah, I see a vibe change.
Yeah. Well, you had a great game tonight, and congratulations to the whole team.
Thank you.
All right. Thanks. All right, Scott Carose here. I'm here with senior Abby Flagel. Abby, so you it's like your first start, right, as a senior. You scored a bucket. You played good defense. You got a couple of rebounds. What did it feel? How did it feel like?
It felt great to just get in and play finally. I'm not really a starter, and I don't get that much playing time, but I try to stay positive, and when I get opportunities, I try and capitalize on them.
You know, Al and I were talking about you during the game, and, you know, it's players like you that really make teams like yours better, because you're the one who pushes everybody in practice. You're the one who comes in games, you know, coming off the bench when people need a break. So tell me a little bit about your basket. You just had an awesome, like, move to the left. Tell me about that.
Well, I actually had a move like that in practice yesterday where I just saw the lane and just went for it on my left hand, and I felt confident with it in the game today because I made it in practice. So.
Well, great job, and great job by the whole team.
Thank you.
And congratulations on being a senior.
Thank you.
All right. All right, Scott Carose, I'm here with Casey Britton Doucette. You played a lot of minutes tonight. Tired?
I'm okay.
You're okay?
Yeah.
You had a really good game defensively. You had a lot of blocks and nice three-point shot.
Thank you.
What did it feel like playing in your last kind of, you know, game as a senior here?
It's definitely sad. I mean, this is the last time I'll be stepping on this court.
Maybe
and playing
not.
With this team.
Maybe. Could Hopefully, you have a playoff game here?
I mean, it doesn't look so great.
Maybe.
Being in the top eight, but there's definitely a chance.
There's a possibility.
Yeah.
So tell me a little bit about the game tonight. I mean, it looked like they had a height advantage, and they were putting, like, taller players on our guards. What was the coach's strategy in terms of, you know, your play, and what was the offensive strategy tonight?
Well, overall as a team, we're a pretty short team, so we do face a lot of height disadvantages. As a team, mainly we just try and double team or help out each other a whole lot more communication when it comes to defense, especially when they're putting taller players on our smaller guards.
Well, I want to wish you the best of luck in your future. What's your plans after graduation? You have anything in plan yet?
I'm actually planning to attend Regis College to play basketball there and continue my career.
Well, super. Congratulations and a great game.
Thank you.